So, yes, oh my, the lighting is, far from perfect. But, hey, that could be my middle name. My code name. Far from perfect. So, hey, here I am. Man, everything just gets dusty. It's really scary how dusty things get. I actually just cleared away some really scary spider webs from our Diana the Huntress statue over here that horrified me. Oh yeah, see, I shouldn't even be doing this on camera, but it just goes to solidify my far from perfect disclaimer, which is just, hey, that's how it goes. Sometimes shit is far from perfect. So I guess that's kind of how I'm feeling, kind of what led me to my poem today. It gets harder sometimes to do these every day, even though my heart is in it and my mind is in it and my soul is in it and the goal is in it, 365 days in it to win it, in it. But I, it's just this imbalance of having hundreds of friends, hundreds, and 80 subscribers, like cranking out this soul material every day and getting like 4 views, 5 views, 6 views. Yeah. I'm here at my Victorian desk, my vintage antique-y desk, and I am doing my best at my Victorian desk. Could I have gone into the depths? Could I have gone? Now I'm in like an OCD zone where I'm like, better get that Swiffer duster. Better grab that sucker. Could I have gone to the depths of my basement and pulled out a Victorian costume to match this table? Yes. Yes, I could have. Did I choose instead to be a bear from a fable? Yes, I did. Because, you know, I see a lot of stuff on the old tubes of you. The use of tubes, and, you know, people do a little Victorian costume diving. Here's this Victorian thing, let me talk about it. I get like 46,000 views. Do I have the energy right now to, pull Victorian garments from my basement for a handful of views? No, I don't. But another factor in wearing this is it's just cold. It's just getting to be that time of year where I am pretty much perpetually cold and shivering and must wear many layers, but this shall suffice with one layer because it's a frickin' bear. And so, yeah. I care, and I'm a bear. And I have used it in another video, but that's okay, because I'm just getting by doing my poetry. Sorry, I'm trying to sneak glimpses of the Bachelorette. Forgive me. I know it's not really forgivable. Part of the reason I decided to use my musty, dusty, desk over here was to, oh wow, all kinds of unknowns in here. Oh, here we go. Part of it was kind of showing this in this sort of weird, sad feeling I'm unfortunately having in my heart. I don't know, gosh, I put a lot of effort into things, into people and life and friendships and all of it. A thing that I really enjoy doing is, and I did a bit of this today actually, I go to antique stores and I'll dig through hundreds and hundreds of photos. And whatever it is about certain photos, I mean, I can't tell you the emotion I feel from it is very intense, but certain ones just speak to me. And it's kind of this thing where, like, I just want to live 100,000 lives. And I get really emotional about how, like, this person's life has probably already gone by. And, like, he's in a box at an antique store. But I like to appreciate these people, these images. Look at her amazing face looking at her hat in the mirror. She's checking out her new hat in the mirror and her delightful little shirt. But, oh God, this one is so good. This young boy got a cowboy hat and he's laying in front of his Christmas tree. But yeah, I want to feel everything. I want to live so many different lives. I want to be a part of it all. I don't want any of it to fall away, and it's hard to hold on to. But anywho, I will dig through these boxes of hundreds and hundreds of photos and pick some that just speak to me for one reason or another. And I do this gifting process where, and I have always done this long before I started Teal's The Real Deal. Bleh, bleh, bleh. Can I say my own channel? Teal's The Real Deal. Long before, look at her little attitude. I don't want to have my picture taken. Her name was Hilda. So long before I started my poetry channel, I would find such photographs. This is a great one of a gal with a donkey. And I use my typewriters, of which I have several, to write poetry on the backs of these photos. And I'll find one that maybe reminds me of someone or gives the general essence of someone. Look at them having fun on the ice. Gosh, what a moment. And I've made hundreds of these. Oh, wow, what a handsome fellow. Probably bought him because I was like, wow, he's quite handsome. Dear Marianne, you know I can't think of anything to say, so I'll just say lots of luck. Bob. So sweet. So sweet. These moments from people's life. This guy's also strikingly handsome. Look at those features. My goodness. Wow. This girl dreaming of something. Yeah, so I have lots and lots. I have bags of these somewhere, and I've given hundreds of them. There's a few people giving me a particular soreness in my heart right now, that certainly I have given many of these photography poems to. This is a really good one. Isn't that grand? We're not talking selfies here, people. We're not talking duck lips, look at me. We're talking genuine moments here. So, the particular spot of soreness I have, it's for a few people I know I've given some of these poems to. Oh, great. Oh, great. The old storage game. You know what? We're going to forge ahead. We're going to read the poem. It's a night. I just need to get through it. So, a little bit of sore feelings. This one starts off as a regular poem, and then I got frustrated by that, trying to think things. So I just went into one of the people's text box, who's kind of blowing me off right now, just actually fully blowing me off, and did a swipe poem instead. Oh, is it gonna? Please don't. Just don't stop. Don't stop. I can do it. Okay, so it starts as a regular poem, goes into a swipe poem. Well, hopefully we can get through it. It's called Sigh, Given the Old Go-By. People I never ever dreamed would seem distant from me have scooted away, drastically. The elasticity of connections seemed to be unraveling in big, shocking sections. The reflection of the last few years really gets me in tears. Some of my greatest fears about just being human have not only become real, but zoomed in, so amplified and undeniable, I'm liable to start having aches in my heart. With all this splitting apart of bonds I thought were sealed with eternal love and the power of magic wands, I get to feeling less and less strong when people I'm so endeared to just move along down the line and act like ignoring me is totally fine. I can't really get my mind around it. I'm certainly not cool with this shift, not one bit. I sit reviewing our most recent interactions, pondering if I said something that needs a redaction. A small fraction of my energy is expelled on me, and so very much of it goes swirling outwardly to many others. This cold shoulder business smothers any attempt at being in a good mood. It isn't just annoying and cruel, it's pretty rude. Maybe method. Mark's brisk warding. Call later. Disservices lighten. Listen gainful. Down fist swam push. Offish happening. Hidden section. Check in. Regain orientation. Sustain linkages. Harden. Frozen. Enough. Plodding odd vision. Caustic placid reference. External midnight. Physical heist. Feather layer. Darken lockdown. Forgotten keys. Dunno. Tattoo fix mindset. Duck human exchange. Gosh, essential lack. Lightning disconnect. Actual relic. Grumps, heck, brain harsh. Martian loss. Happening harm. Mean margin. Cyber dramas. Crisp design offshoots. Museum messages. Kindred medication between mindful breathing cushions. Brushed off. Been better. Bearish beaten. Didn't even remember that was in there. Bearish beaten. Hurts. Legit getting less natural. Brisk feel. Basically bruised often. Crushed mystic. Hard nervous behavior gush. Wish crystal candle lighters versus logistics. Finding busy narration. Monsoon marsh. Missing verbal human playing. Forgotten lantern portal. Method hectic mush mental medium. Certain powers. System grown vacuum variation. Poem didn't stick. Riding beauty hard. Harvest reservations. Blanks discuss music. Imminently escape dynamic reservoir. Efficacious bullseye. Efficacious bullseye. Fun. IDK. Sarcastic humor fumigation. Guess null humans. Messy decisions. Mimic harsh maiden circus. Nothing binding. Graphic blushes. Memories static. Errands stuck. Vanish laughter. Melatonin certainly broken. Trusts mush. Inhuman History Month. Thank fuck bullshit. Microscope vendor. Betrayal humdinger. Need. Search. Hustle. Literal bullshit. Sweetened memory echo must have been essential. Maybe numbness magic. Barefoot mystery. Heaviness season. Drawn grid. Blah. Megabits. Handstand mixtape. Owl search. Craving mountain green holding. Monarch beauty crazy burst. Busy, busy, busybody. Email exultant return. Carnival photos. Stardust maker. Brazen laugh. Ha 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 ha. Ha ha ha. Fetching meaning. Luminary vessels. Mixed up indigo. Mission modern. Matter muddy. Nostalgic season. So yeah, I don't know. Jeez. Kind of feeling sad about all that, I guess. This is cool that I said monarch beauty crazy burst. And here's a book with a monarch on it, right there. That's kind of a lovely thing. Being ignored, not so lovely, especially by people that you, like, love and have given a lot to. It's a hard feeling. So everybody's in a weird space right now, that's for sure, and my phone is out of space. So there's a taste of things I feel, and I shall reveal more on the day next after this one. What fun. Bye now.